Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys how to pre-grade multicam clips prior to editorial. Now to make a multicam clip, you select your cameras, right-click, and say create new multicam clip using selected clips. You can give it a unique name, a frame rate. You can differentiate how you want them to sync, whether it's in and out markers, time code, or sound. In this case, we're going to use sound, and we're going to say automatic. That way you can listen to all the channels in case one doesn't let it sync. Sometimes you'll get an error. And then you can choose whether to move it into our original clips bin or leave it. I've already made this clip. Normally you'd hit create. So now that threw a multicam clip right into here, and you could tell it's multicam, the little icon in the corner showing the multiple squares. And when we preview it, you can see both clips. Now here's the secret to lining them up. Right click, say open in timeline, and now this is your multicam folder bin. So anything you do in here is unique to just this multicam clip. It's actually not changing the original files. So if you resize or make an adjustment, this is unique to only the files that are in here. So right now I sync them up with a hand clap. And then to color each of these independently, what you'll need to do is disable your second angle or whatever, however many angles you have. So starting on angle one, make sure that's the only thing visible. Highlight it and hit shift 6 to go to the color page. Now you can see here's camera A, and we'll give it a little bit of an adjustment here. Maybe drop down the black level a little bit and we'll give it some highlight and maybe bring down the gamma. Okay, so there's the difference. Let's give it a little more saturation just so we could tell it apart a little bit more. So there's before, after. All right, then you go to your next clip. So I'm going to disable camera A and go to camera B and enable that. Shift 6. Now we're looking at the second camera angle. So we're going to make some adjustments here. Before and after grade. There we go. So now each camera, if we go to A, you can see before and after. And if we go to B, before and after. So they're both just a little more saturated and bright looking. So now these two clips are graded inside the multicam timeline. So think of it as the multicam timeline holds the clips together and makes them a bundle. So you can't just pre-grade these clips from the original clips. We did put a LUT on them, but to have these adjustments that we just made, once you add them to a multicam clip, that's the only place they're referenced is inside the multicam clip. So now we're going to get rid of that. And we have a 2997 timeline here, and I've already put down from the multicam clip angle one as a base layer. And you could see the grade matches what we have done previously. If you want to start cutting angles from your multicam clip, turn on your dual screen viewer, drop your multicam clip into your source, and very important, from this drop down menu, choose multicam. And now when you play, all the action from the multicam clip will match where you're at in your timeline. So let's say we wanted to cut to angle two right here. We could hit cam two on our speed editor, or you can hit the razor blade, whichever one you need. So let's undo that and say we wanted to cut to camera two. Just hover over camera two, click it, and it'll switch. Let's say we wanted to switch back to angle one here. We could double click it. And if you didn't like that, you can hit option and you can see your icon changes to a little film strip with arrows. This is a swap clip. So let's click that and we will say swap it with angle two here. So now on our timeline, we cut back and forth. So you can go back and forth. Everything's pre-graded when you're done with your edit. You don't have to go back and color any individual shots. And if you do need to make an adjustment, go back to your multicam clip, right click, open in timeline, and access your individual cameras that way. You still have the flexibility to adjust it after the fact, but then when you're editing it on this timeline, your grade's already baked in. All right, I hope that helps. Thanks for watching as always. I'll talk to you guys on the next one.